on a very serious note, you are an open book about your relationship. You're very open with people about you and Derek, and yeah.
You have to be.
At one point last year, you announced that the two of you were having a baby, that the surrogate, using a surrogate.
Yeah.
Later, she miscarried, and I know for you, having gone through many miscarriages myself, I know how hard that is, because you make plans the minute you find out that you're going to have a child. So how have you been dealing with this, the two of you?
Oh, my God.
Because it was very public, and your joy was very public, you know?
Well, I think I announced it a little too early, maybe, because just the person I am, and I was so happy and excited
and
in love and all those things. And then, you know, and I feel for our surrogate, because it's not even my body, and yet I was so destroyed and so sad. And I chose to, I did announce it, that because people were congratulating me and us, and people were sending baby gifts, and you know how it is.
I absolutely know.
You build this thing inside of you, and my whole adult life, I've been wanting to be a father. And the nice thing about that sadness and putting it out there is that there's a huge amount of support. And it's like a subject a lot of people don't talk about for some reason. And now, you know, time has passed, and we're hopeful, we're trying again, and you know, we're not gonna let that sadness stop us.
Right.
But it's it was difficult, very difficult.
And I have to say, Fredrik, that even from my own experience, once I did start talking about it myself, having miscarriages, the feedback you get from other people who have been in the same situation and felt isolated, you're helping them to feel that they're not alone, that it happens to a lot of people.
I think
you know?
So. It's good to talk about it.
Yeah.